Now, let us write down output of balance modulator 4, which is the last balance modulator. The inputs to balance modulator 4 is nothing but signal at point F. The signal at point F is something we have written here. And the second input is my carrier signal with frequency omega C1 without any phase shift. So both this signal enter into the balance modulator 4. So let us multiply the two signals. We will get cos of omega C1 t multiplied with cos of omega naught t minus omega m t. That's the signal coming from point F. So again, because you are multiplying two cosine functions, we will add and subtract the angles. So the first angle, when they are added, will become cos omega C1 t plus omega naught t minus omega m t. Plus, let us now take a minus b part. That will give you cos omega C1 t minus omega naught, because you are doing a minus b, so minus omega naught, and it will become plus omega m t. So that's the output of balance modulator 4. And finally, these two outputs, you are going to add them together. So we are adding output of balance modulator 3 and output of balance modulator 4. If you carefully observe, the second term in both the outputs is exactly same. So when you add them, you will get twice cos of this whole thing. Whereas look at the first term, the frequencies are exactly same. Omega C1 plus omega naught minus omega m. Similarly, here also we have omega C1 plus omega naught minus omega m. But if you look at the phase difference between them, the phase difference is 180 degree. And we had already seen that whenever you add two cosine functions with the same frequency but out of phase by 180 degree, then they will simply cancel each other. So when you add the two signals, these two terms will cancel out, and we will have output, which is output at point D, in the form of twice cos of this whole thing. So let me just write down the final output. The final output at point D will be twice cos of omega C1 t minus omega naught t plus omega m t. And I'm going to further write this as 2 cos. I will keep t aside. So omega C1 minus omega naught t plus omega m t. And I will quickly replace omega C1 minus omega naught as omega c t plus omega m t. So if you carefully observe, what we have got at the output is nothing but the upper sideband. So we have successfully achieved only the upper sideband. There is no lower sideband present at the output side, and hence we have suppressed the lower sideband in this whole operation, which uses four different balance modulators. If you remember, I told you there's a relationship between omega C, omega naught, and omega C1. So if you now carefully observe, the relationship is nothing but that omega C is omega C1 minus omega naught. So the final carrier frequency that I want, omega C, that has to be omega C1 minus omega naught. So that is how you will generate the values omega C1 and omega naught, so that when you subtract them, you get the frequency omega C. So I repeat, we have avoided two important things. We are not using filters operating at high frequencies. We are using low pass filters, but they are going to operate at frequency omega naught, which is AF carrier, which is a low frequency carrier. And we are not using 90 degree phase shifters, which will have to provide phase shift to the range of frequencies. Both these 90 degree phase shifters will provide phase shift to single frequencies, omega C1 and omega not. And hence, both the drawbacks of filter and phase shift methods are overcome. But in process of overcoming these two drawbacks, you can see that we have complicated the entire block diagram. There are four balance modulators being used, and please remember that these balance modulators will be nothing but those diode balance modulators or ring modulator circuits that we have discussed. There are four balance modulators. There are two carrier generators that we require. So this whole block diagram is much more complicated than the previous two methods. Commercially, we never use the third method. We study the third method, but it is never used in the practical AM systems. We also avoid using phase shift method due to the problem of having phase shifter providing phase shift over a range of frequencies. We go back to the filter method because with very advanced filter design technology that is available nowadays, the filter method turns out to be the best method to generate single sideband. Please remember that initially there was a problem of designing filters at high frequencies, but we had also overcome that in the modified diagram. So in the modified diagram of filter method, we were using filters, but they were operating at low frequencies, something similar to the third method. So we actually cannot still say that the filter method has the drawback which is overcome in the third method. So one of the best methods that is used for the SSB generation is filter method. Let us now go to the next part of SSB system, in which we will receive the SSB system and carry out its demodulation.